Hello everyone, today we'll be talking about summer flowers. We will not get into a technical things, but today we will appreciate their beauty. We will try to understand and connect with them. See, I have selected this topic because in this season there are many flowers which are ready to showcase their beauty. See, monsoon is most all about greenery and green, and summer is mostly about red. So let's start. In India, summer season is considered from March to May or early June, but due to rain patterns, temperature, things got disturbed a bit, and flowering in some got delayed and in other it got early. So in this talk we'll be talking about plants which are usually or naturally are in flowering between March to June. So let's start with March, and March is a time for Holi. होली कब है होली? आंसर टू दिस आइकॉनिक क्वेश्चन इन ओल्डन डे वॉज, देखो भैया जब पलाश का फूल लगेंगे तब है होली. इन ओल्डन डे ब्लूमिंग ऑफ अ पलाश वॉज एन इंडिकेटर दैट होली इज राउंड द कॉर्नर. इन विलेजेस किड वेटेड फॉर दिस फ्लावर एज दिस वॉज अ सोर्स ऑफ द होली कलर, एंड वन डजन हैव टू पुट एन एफर्ट और ब्रेन टू एक्सट्रैक्ट अ कलर फ्रॉम दिस. ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज टेक फ्लावर और नॉर्मल टैप वाटर, देयर यू गो. It will palash will give you all the color you want. You can pray it again. Take flower, pour water, boom. It gives you all the color you want. Oh, palash flowers are not only good for skin, but they are remedy for many kind of skin diseases, which make it as an ideal color for Holi. You know, since ages, palash is synonym of Holi. In earlier days, this were our color, palash, turmeric, which nourishes our skin, unlike nowadays color, which are completely opposite. Now, coming to palash flower. Palash flower is also known as skin shaker, which means parrot beak, which resembles a parrot beak. It is also known as flame of the forest, and you can understand that by looking at this picture. See, when it's in flowering season, it drops all its leaf to showcase its flower. And if you see this plant from far away, it does look like there is a flame in a forest. Such a fiery orange color flower it has. Palash Sharbat. Tribal area of Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh have this tradition of drinking Palash Sharbat as a coolant, which has nutrition and healing quality. To make this sharbat, they just soak flower in water, just like we saw it in a previous video, and they add jaggery for sweetness and soft for the flavor. There are many recipes available on YouTube regarding Palash Sharbat, and India has this tradition of coolant. We have number of indigenous coolant like gulab sharbat, ampanna, sauf, jaljeera, kokum, mint, karwand, falsa. All these are lost or replaced by the coke and soda what we get nowadays, and this coke and soda fills your body with high level of harmful sugar. No, so this summer try this indigenous coolant. Replace your coke and soda with this indigenous coolant. I have named very few indigenous drink. You can try other and share. Look, I know this is a summer flower talk, but wherever I feel plant got an interesting leaf, fruit or bark, I'll share information regarding that. So this is a palash leaf, and most of you might have used this as a plate or to wrap food. And it's good to see that after plastic ban, people are coming back to the leaves. Now, this leaf plate of palash leaf plate take around 30 days to degrade, and plastic takes almost 1,000 years, and styrofoam, that is thermocol plates, take 500 years. Just imagine we use this plate for few minutes and throw, and it take years to degrade it. Erythrina. Next we'll be talking about erythrina, which is also known as pangara, and it's also known as Indian coral tree. We'll talk about its pollination first. This is its pollination. Let me clear one thing. This is a picture of swallowtail hummingbird, and I know hummingbird are not found in India, but I've selected this and next picture because it's explained pollination perfectly. See, flower and pollinator are are like partners. Sometimes these flowers are designed for specific type of pollinator. You can see here, Pangara has this pointed flowers, so bird with pointed beak can peek into it and can use its beak just like a straw to drink a nectar. While doing so, pollen get dusted on its head or below its beak. In this case, it's below beak. I've just zoomed this picture and observed pollen grain. Now see another case where bird with small and blunt beak want to have a nectar. He know that he can't peek into a flower from main entrance. This is a main entrance. He can't reach till a nectar point from a main entrance. So he takes a shortcut, make a hole where nectar is stored and have it. What he is doing is called nectar robbery or stealing. Why? Because he is not helping a plant in pollination. Plant are not here to give free nectar. Nectar is a reward for doing pollination or carrying a pollen. After taking a nectar, animals are expected to provide a service of pollination. If they don't do it, they are considered as a nectar robber. Not only birds, but the many bee, wasp and ants which are found to do this kind of nectar stealing in plants. So to deal with this nectar stealing, even plants evolve. Some has made this strong sepal and petals so that this robber can't easily chew or tear them. Some plants know that mera pollinator subah 7 baje aata hai, so they make concentrated nectar at that time. And there are many ways in which plant evolve to protect themselves from this nectar robber. And at the same time, even animal evolve to break this barrier. It's like if you're smart, then I'm over smart. If you're over smart, I'll try to outsmart you. So this was about Erythrina flowers, pollination and nectar stealing. Let's see Erythrina leaves. Saurashtran of Madurai make vada out of Erythrina leaf. These Saurashtran are migrated from southern Gujarat after fall of Somnath temple when Mohammad Ghazni invaded India. That's fine, but why they make vada out of Erythrina leaves? See, Saurashtrans are well known for making their fine silk garment. And when working on it, there are chances of fine dust and fiber from silk thread getting into their lungs and causing respiratory problem. That's why leaves of Pangara were added into their snack or vada. It is believed that these leaves have this medicinal value in treating respiratory issues. So they use it, this as a medicinal thing, mixed with, used as a snack. Next we have Bombax ceiba, also known as Kate Sarwar or Snemal. Let's first understand a kate and afterwards flower. See, botanically there are three things: prickles, spines and thorns. Prickles are on plant epidermis. So we'll first talk about prickles, and prickles are on plant epidermis. Epidermis means outer layer. As they are on outer layer, it's easy to remove them. The best example of it is a rose. You might have removed a rose prickle in your life. No, I often give this example that if you are in love, you can do that. He loves me and he loves me not with the petal. And if you had a breakup, same thing you can do with the prickles. Petal and prickle both are useful depending upon the situation. Okay, what I want you to remember that prickles are present on the outer layer and they are easy to remove. Next, we'll talk about spines. Spines are modified leaves and they're a bit difficult to remove it. Thorns are modified stem and they are deeply embedded, not possible to remove them with the hand. Now, kate sour ka kate are example of prickle. And people do remove it and rub it on a stone, just like one would rub a sandalwood, and that paste is applied on pimple or acne. Some people do eat prickle as a supari. Coming to sour, this is sour flower. Semal or kate sarwar is an ecologically important tree as it provides a nectar to many birds. Just look at this flower. Its shape is just like a bowl filled with a nectar. People call this as a bird magnet as many birds visit this plant during flowering season. You can get a long checklist of birds if you just sit opposite to this tree. There are many interesting uses of this flowers. Tribal women collect a fallen flower bud Let me repeat what I've said. Fallen, flower, bird. And they have to collect a fallen one because it's catty sour. Not easy to climb tree surrounded by the prickles, right? Not easy to climb this tree surrounded by the prickles. So in nature, plant do abort flower bud for various reasons. Like if it's not, they're not able, plant is not able to provide water and nutrition to all the birds. Some are aborted. Apart from this, the other reasons like heat, light, hormone deficiency. And let me clear one thing, that it's pretty much common in nature to abort some flower. This collected flower buds shelf is about 4 days, and if tribal women collect more flower bud, they peel, chop and sun dry them to preserve it. And this semal ki sabji is made up of this flower bud calyx. You can see this calyx. So only this green part is used, rest all the things are thrown off. So petals and only green are not used, petals are not used, only these sepals are used. And I thought that this sabji only tribals eat it, but I was wrong. There are many videos and blogs available on internet which tells you this, that the semal ki sabji is it's not that rare. Moving on, this is a fruit of semal, like, or Bombax ceiba is also known as red silk cotton tree. Now red referred to flower and silk cotton refer to this mature fruit of this plant produce a white fiber like cotton, and inside this cotton the seeds present, and this cotton like material used for stuffing pillow cushions and for packing material. So this was all about Bombax. Let's move to next plant, that is kusum. Kusum in Sanskrit means flower. Now this tree is called kusum because it's young new leaf or young red leaf look like a flower. They look like a flower, that's why. And it is named kusum because of its leaf. So when you see this plant in a while, you will fall in love with it. And you will agree that its leaves are more beautiful than a flower. And they're amazing. So, and how flower looks. These are the flower. You can see that it has a tiny whitish green flower which are hardly noticeable. So how they attract a pollinator? Now, see, flower are much wiser than we think. This flower blooms at the same time when new bright leaves come. So they bloom right below this young leaves, and which you can see in this picture. And this is their hack to attract a pollinator. Once pollinator get attracted by looking at this red leaves, flowers are right below it, and boom, their job is done. Kusum, this is a kusum tree, you know. This is how its look, and it looks more beautiful. You know, this picture can't justify beauty of kusum in a wild. Kusum tree is also known as massacre. Kusum is also known as massacre oil tree. Massacre oil was used by European men as a hair conditioner to groom and style their hair. Just like nowadays men use gel to groom their hair, at that time they were using this massacre oil. And barber at that time used to make their own oil. So this massacre oil was prepared by one of the celebrity barber, and he used kusum oil, coconut oil, palm oil and many other stuff to make this massacre oil. And he aggressively advertised it with exaggerated claims, which made it huge popular. It was popular, but there was one problem with this massacre oil. This oil was too greasy, and whenever men used to sit or rest, wherever they used to sit or rest, they would leave their oily or greasy mark. So if men used to sit on this, they're sitting on this sofa, they would leave this greasy mark on the sofa. So this led to an invention of anti-massacre. A small cloth was placed over back of armchair because because see, it's difficult to clean this entire furniture. So sasta, tikau, removable and washable anti-masker was used to prevent masker oil marks. So this was about kusum or masker oil tree. Moving on next, neem. In most of the plant, flower are the most noticeable and appreciated part. But in case of neem, due to dominance of neem twig which we use in India as a dhatu and leaves which we use it as insecticide, flower got separated somewhere. And you know, neem tree is also known as village pharmacy, since every part of the tree from bark to flower can be used for various purpose, medicinal purpose. And this flower, tiny white flower, blooms once in afternoon and then again in the evening. And in South Indian cooking, neem flowers are used for making number of dishes like flour, rice, chutney, rasam. The many uses of this. They use this flower in dry form or fresh form, and they even use this to garnish the many kind of dishes. And another interesting use of neem flower is they have this calming effect. That's why it is used in aromatherapy. Nowadays, people are coming with a new neem product. Like this is a neem wood, which we say it's 100% pure herbal. I've seen this at Kalagoda festival. Good to see that people are coming with new products. Moving on, we have next plant, that is mauva. See, in central India, for many tribals, mauva is not just a tree, it's more than that. It's their food, culture, religion, mythology, god and everything. See, when they decide to clear a forest for farming, all trees will be cut except mauva, because it's far too precious to cut. There is a tribal saying, heaven is where there are mauva trees and hell is where there is no mauva tree. So let's first understand mauva flower. This is a mauva flower. The brown thing which you can see is a calyx, and white globular thing are few petals. And you have named them. This thing which is peeping out of petal is a style. Style means a female part of the plant. Moving on, next we have this mauva flower. Let's first understand mauva flower. This brown thing is a calyx. The white globular are few petal. One which is peeping out of the flower is a female part, that is, which is known as style. Male part are inside the petals. So after pollination, let me repeat what I have said. After pollination, all the part of the flowers are fallen except a female part. This female part remain attached to the plant, and this female part later gets pregnant and turn into a fruit. Other part of the flowers are fallen off because their job is done. See, petal and sepal job is to protect a female till pollination. Male part function is to provide a pollen during pollination. So after pollination, plant drop all this part because now there is no point in carrying them and providing nutrients to them. These fused petals which are dropped by a plant are so precious to the people that they sit under tree to guard them. There is a race to collect these petals, not only with humans but also with other creatures. When mauva flower or fused petals fall on the dry leaves, they are completely camouflaged. It's difficult to spot them. And I've told you there is a race to collect them. So people earlier used to burn area around below mauva tree. All dry leaves used to turn into ashes, and in this ashes blows a mauva flower, and it's easier to collect when they blow on these ashes. Mauva flower don't get affected by the fire. Many of you might be knowing Mawa because of the Mawa drink, but not only drink, there are many dishes are made up of Mawa flour. As I told you, it's their food. So Mawa roti, bhakri, ladu, chikki. There are many, many, many kind of dishes. I've named very few, but there are many dishes are made by the tribal from Mawa flowers. Even bear love to consume Mawa flower, and even he likes to get high on it. So to avoid human and animal conflict, forest department advise people to venture out in a forest in a group, make some noise, so to avoid this bear, and bear can get alert when humans are around. Next we have Sitashok. Shok means sorrow and Ashoka means sorrowless. So in Ramayana there is a reference of Ashoka Vatika, garden of Ashok tree, and it's believed that Sita stayed at Ashok Vatika until the end of epic battle between Rama and Ravana. Therefore this tree is also known as Sita Ashok. Now observe this flower carefully. You will notice that there are two kind of flower. One has a yellow flower and another has a orangish red color. Think for a while what could be a reason. They are trying to say something. Just like animal communicate with call, even plant communicate. As I have told you, plant and animal are pollinator and they are partners. Plant and pollinator are partners. Therefore, they need to communicate. So this flower is the best example of plant and animal interaction. This flower change color after pollination. Let me repeat. This flower change color after pollination, telling his pollinator that I don't have a nectar. Please don't waste your time on me. Now look at the flower. Yellow color means I have a nectar. For plant also means that not pollinated. Red color means I don't have a nectar. Flower change color to be more efficient and to save time of itself and pollinator. Imagine if every time pollinator visit these flowers and don't find a nectar, next time his chances of visiting will be less. There may be chances that he may not visit a next time. So, and there are many changes which are happening in the flower. We can't see them with our naked eyes, like this one, change in a color, because these are not done for us. It is for pollinator. If pollinator can see yellow color easily, then unpollinated flower or nectar full flower will be in yellow color. So this was about Ashoka flower. Let's moving on. Ashoka, a plant, if you have seen, it has dark green, not that dark, but green color mature leaf and pink color young leaves. Not only Ashok plant, but there are many plants which have pink or red color young leaves. For example, mango, peepal, kusum we have seen. So this slide is reference to all. Why plant has pink or red color leaves and pink or red color leaves when they are young? So these are a few theories. One of it is pink color leaves, pink flower leaves are pink in color because they have this anthocyanins pigment. It's a kind of adaptation. What adaptation? Anthocyanin act as a sunscreen by protecting a cell from a UV rays and thereby protecting the leaves, young leaves, from too much of light. There are some herbivores like aphid, they can't see red color. So leaves are protected from them. And most of you might be knowing that red color is also a warning signal in nature. Red is considered as a warning signal. So many, many herbivores don't come near this red leaves. And anthocyanin present in leaf also protect a leaf from fungal attack. So this was a few theory why young leaves are pink in color. Asopalava, I've selected this slide because many people often mystic Asopalava as an Ashok. And it is completely different from Sita Ashok. It has a wavy leaves, and Sita Ashok has more a wide canopy, and Asopalava mostly has this cone shaped canopy. It's completely different from Sita Ashok. It is Asopalava, and that is Ashok. Moving on, Amaltash is also known as Golden Shower Tree. It is a state tree of Kerala. The flowers of Amaltash are ritual, has a ritual importance in Vishu festival of Kerala. It's a national flower of Thailand and symbol of Thai royalty. In most of the acacia species has this two type of stamen, short infertile and long fertile one. And why they have this two type of stamen, and top of it, why infertile stamen? What can be reason for it? If it has, so what can be a reason? See, most of the acacia species, this long stamen, long and fertile. Fertile means they're obviously used for pollination. Short one, which are infertile, what they are for? They act as a food for pollinator or a reward for a bee for doing a pollination. Again, acacia flower, this was about why acacia flower has these two kind of stamens. Moving on, acacia flower has this culinary use. See, there are many, I've told you about neem flower, semal also. The many flower which are edible, but while cooking, most of the flower, we remove this male and female plant. Why? Because they add bitterness to the dish. And remember one thing, for cooking anything, identification of ingredient is very important. So if you cook palak thinking it as a methi, it will not affect you, but if you pick wrong flower, it will. See, recipes are available on internet, but identification is something you have to do it. There are many plant identification Facebook group which can help you with the identification. Okay, so identification is a key. Moving on, Gulmohar. Have you ever seen Gulmohar? If you have, then you might have wondered why it has four red petal and one odd petal. Now it has all, why don't it has all red petal? What problem it will have it if it has all red petals? Now imagine yourself as a pollinator sitting in a center of the flower, and all petals are red in color, and nectar is stored below one of this red petal. So in order to get nectar, you have to peek below every petal. It's time consuming, it's irritating. Pollinator may feel, are yaar, ye gulmohar pe treasure hunt khelne se acha, I'll go somewhere else and find the nectar. There are chances pollinator may not visit this flower next time. So to make pollinator's job easy, flower has this one odd petal and nectar is stored right below it. See, both androecium and gynoecium are curved and almost standing opposite to this odd petal to dust or receive a pollen grain. And you know, these four red petals are like advertisement, like either. And like advertisement to attract a pollinator. And pollinator visit a flower, first thing comes into his mind, ab aa to gaya hai, jana kidhar hai. In that case, this odd petal act as a nectar guide, signaling either I have a nectar. So this is reason why gulmohar have this one odd petal to make pollination more efficient. So gulmohar is also known as Mayflower because it's bloom in May. And there is a city in Maharashtra called Satara, which every year celebrate Gulmohar Day on 1st May. So there is this place in Satara where there are many Gulmohar tree. So people sit under shade of Gulmohar, write poems, story, do painting, exhibit their Gulmohar photography. The motto of this festival is to appreciate Gulmohar flower. सातारा इज सेलिब्रेटिंग दिस गुलमोहर डे सिंस लास्ट 20 ईयर, एंड आई फील सुपर प्राउड व्हेन आई केम टू नो अबाउट दिस. यू नो वी जस्ट नीड टू सेलिब्रेट मोर सच फेस्टिवल टू कीप आर नेक्स्ट जनरेशन कनेक्टेड विद द नेचर. वी हैव टू कम अप विद, वी कैन कम अप विद अमरताज फेस्टिवल एंड मेनी अदर सच फेस्टिवल. मूविंग ऑन नेक्स्ट इज कॉपर पॉट. कॉपर पॉट बाय लुकिंग एट द पिक्चर यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड वाई दिस प्लांट इज कॉल्ड कॉपर पॉट, बिकॉज इट हैज कॉपरी पॉट. ड्यूरिंग फ्रूटिंग सीजन इफ यू सी दिस प्लांट कैनोपी यू कैन लिटरली फील दैट कॉपर इज हैंगिंग ऑन इट. यू नो जस्ट लाइक अपना टाइम आएगा, दिस इज अ टाइम फॉर कॉपर पॉट. आई हैव एडेड दिस प्लांट बिकॉज वेन एवर आई सी आउटसाइड माई विंडो ऑल आई कैन सी इज दिस प्लांट canopy is full of yellow flower which has calming effect. It's like a treat to the eyes. It has such a color of positivity, such a color that it feel good, you know. And whenever these plants are there, these are the plants of wherever they are going growing, they will lay a carpet of yellow flower below it. This is a picture of Sanjay Gandhi National Park which recently got viral. This plant lays a yellow carpet wherever it grows. It's beautiful, but for the sweeper it's a pain in the back. The bark of this tree yields a yellow brown dye which is useful for dyeing clothes, dyeing cotton or batik product. Batik is an Indonesia technique using melted wax which has different motif and pattern. I want to share one more interesting fact about batik. In Indonesia, every year they celebrate National Batik Day on 2nd October, and most of them wear batik, and there are a lot of benefit given to a people who wear batik on that day, such as discount in many shops, free voucher. I think on same day, that is 2nd October, even we can celebrate a Khadi Day. In fact, there are many people who started wearing khadi and celebrating Khadi Day on Gandhi Jayanti. So I end my presentation. I just want to end this session by saying one last thing. Stay safe, stay at home, keep learning. Thank you very much.